done these songs we haven't done for years, so lots of sort of purpose. Right in the middle, get it adjusted to your height. Tell us what you want to do.
I think as every camper who came here this weekend can attest that Nick and John's music has been a kind of a soundtrack to our lives. And what's really kind of a wonderful thing is I have two daughters, 24 and 26, and it's become the soundtrack to their lives because, you know, you sing to them when they're little and they hear the music drifting through the house. And I remember when my youngest daughter was in college, she called me and she said, gee, there was something on the Tonight Show and there was a tune and Jay Leno was trying to figure out who sang it and the guests there couldn't remember. And there were a whole bunch of girls in the sorority and my daughter stands up and said, it's the Kingston Trio. It's the Kingston Trio. And so this particular song is one that I'm gonna try to do. It's I'm gonna sing it to my daughter's wedding in about 4 weeks and it's called Turn Around.
No, I'm not going to play. Loudly, so we'll not be playing some nut singing.
Now, don't put that cable's on. The cable's on. Here comes right up the back street.
bunch of guys. Narrowly, I went back and tried to explain to my wife, who, you know, says, what the hell are you doing over there? Who are these people coming over to me?
She
did. Yeah, she did. You know. I said, well, not only are they, like, lifelong fans and great musicians, not all great, the trio was never great as far as musicianship was concerned, but they also, my dear, have a life, and which is a lot different than, you know, a lot of people, and they're a wonderful bunch of guys. Speaking for myself. The shorts guy in the group anymore. Thank God, after 25 years.
No, I think he's still on. No.
What's your first?
Hammering tacks in my head to attract lightning.
I am Dick's mother's. Miss Mary, where are you wandering? Oh, Miss Mary, where are you wandering? Oh, Miss Mary, where are you wandering? Bring it, and Mary's coming home. When Mary was a young girl, she took to wandering. Never would she leave me and not come back again. Swear I'd hear her singing, singing in the western wind. 3 days and Mary's coming home. Oh, Miss Mary, where are you wandering? Oh, Miss Mary, where are you wandering? Oh, Miss Mary, where are you wandering? 3 days and Mary's coming home. So many rivers flow that I can't count them. She wouldn't want those rainbows even if she found them. 3 days and Mary's coming home. Coming home. coming.
One more time.
Hey. Oh, Miss Mary, where are you wandering? Oh, Miss Mary, where are you wandering? Oh, Miss Mary, where are you wandering? 3 days and Mary's coming. 3 days and Mary's coming. 3 days and Mary's coming.
Delicious dinner at Senior Methane's. And the second one was for being on the planet at the same two guys, at the same time as these two guys.
Thank you, John. We were not always here. Charlie. That's what I was going to say. Yes. Now I'm okay.
Such a kick to look across and see you singing that song.
What's so wrong? I know. It's such a kick to be have the shirts on and doing this. Come on. There was nothing.
Putting on the striped shirt tonight was like, I remember I used to call it getting into the suit of lights. Jesus.
Well, you know, Travis.
That and
Bobby used
a jammer
shirt or something.
Rich Gonzalez.
Rich Gonzalez.
Yes.
I think.
Yeah, you see, one of the problems with John's random method of selecting the campers of the order of songs is occasionally you're going to get the same song twice.
Thank you.
Woo!
And we're going to do a song.
Would you like to come back later?
I'm fine.
Cool. No, you sing up, we're going to trade verses, kind of like
absolutely.
You did then.
Yeah.
And we'll just kind of
like,
you're singing the melody, though.
It was important that we could do a song associated with Nick, because like most people, I always thought he was the coolest member of the team.
Rich is now a cross-dresser.
On this one, you can help us. That'll make the difference.
That's right.
Okay. Well, let me tell you the story of a man named Charlie on that tragic, fateful day.
Tell him, Nick.
He his pocket, this is wife and family went to round the MTA. Will he ever return? No, he never returned. And his fate is still unlearned. He may ride forever near the streets of Boston. He's a man who never returned.
Alright. Poor Charlie had to give his time at the Kendall Square station, and he had to change a man. When he got there, the conductor told him one more nickel. Charlie couldn't get off of that train.
Will he ever return? No, he never returned. And his fate is still unlearned. He may ride forever beneath the streets in Boston. He's a man who never returned. Now all night long, Charlie rides from the station crying, what will be? Chelsea, oh, my cousins in Roxbury.
Will he ever return? No, he never returned. And his fate is still unlearned. He may ride forever beneath the streets of Boston. He's a man who never returned. Charlie's wife goes down to the Kendall Square station every day at 2:15. And through the open window, she hands Tom Delilah Guinness as the train comes on.
Will he ever return? No, he never returned. And his fate is still unlearned. He may ride forever beneath the streets of Boston. He's the man who never returned.
Watch his fingers, folks. They never leave his hands.
Citizens of Boston, don't you think it's a scandal how the people have to pay and pay? Fight the fairy priest, vote for George O'Brien, get poor Charlie off the MTA. But did he ever return? No, he never returned, and his fate is still unlearned. He may ride forever beneath the streets of Boston. He's the man who never returned. He's the man who never returned. He's the man who never returned.
day to Johnny.
Campers here that actually used to be a local and grew up in Phoenix.
Smart. Wow. Yeah, you got it.
And I used to watch this guy at the Celebrity for years and years and years. And to come back to my hometown and be on the stage with this man is like the world's greatest thing, and to have this young man next to me is like.
Thank you.
Scary as hell. The scariest.
This is my second favorite song we ever recorded. And my favorite, John's.
Yeah, mine too. See, I learned to play guitar from listening to Cannons in the Rain.
Are you playing a C chord? Is that where you start? You start here? Okay, good. That's good.
That, thank you, Ed. Listen.
Gonna find the true love, and that is where I'm.
sing you a song, sing it soft and low. Sing it for you, baby, and then I'll have to go. Out where the chilly winds don't blow, and I'm going where the chilly winds don't blow. Gonna find a true love, that is where I want to go. Out where the chilly winds don't blow. Out where the chilly winds don't blow. Out where the chilly winds don't blow.
Jerry Steinberg.
Jerry Steinberg. Here's my guy.
Here's my guy. How do you pronounce your last name?
Steinberg.
Steinbreaker.
Jared.
Jared.
Jerry. What are we doing, Jerry? Could we do Ringo? Bring back
that one. Let's do Bring Back Dollars.
Let's do that.
Do you want to do the verses?
Let me try the first one.
Sure.
It's the only one I know.
Good. How did you sing this?
Chorus. And I want to thank the audience for being here. That's great.
Oh, yes. Thank you all very much.
Some people say I'm of no account. Others say I'm no good.
Yeah.
and I'm sending to the principal's office.
Have a life too, John. Besides, he's got
not a well man.
Shut up.
He's a lawyer.
Gonzalez is a lawyer.
Hey, banjo man.
Banjo man.
Yeah, I went to the kids at
so I'm going to California.
One of the things we had to do last night was give our group a name. And I played with two other first year guys, so we named ourselves the Virgins. So when I come back next year, I hope I'm not still a virgin.
Me too.
What do you do to be?
I'm an environmental protection specialist.
Are you?
I'm an environmental gas.
Are you a big job? Are you a big job?
No.
Not that way.
I knew what was coming, you just know what's coming.
How about Arden and Arden?
You got it, big boy. G? Is that what you
go to the G?
Yeah. Is that good? Singing on the chorus, right?
Yeah. What are you doing the verses? All three of them?
No, you don't have to.
No.
Oh, yeah.
I can't. You don't have to do one. Heck, I'll do one if you want.
Okay.
What's
the first verse?
Bum, 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 bum.
Do you hear the intro?
Where my true love hangs around, sits down upon another's knee, tells him what she never will tell me.
Oh, but it's hard, ain't it hard, ain't it hard?
Oh, yeah.
To love one who never did love you.
Oh, well, it's hard, ain't it hard, ain't it hard?
Great God, to love one who never will be true.
Look, don't go to
I know that.
say if I had been either.
I wouldn't have known the technicalities of the D string between the wood E, but I knew it sounded like shit.
You don't have to get an answer. There's children here.
Oh, well,
no offense, Dave.
This has got to be one of the greatest things I've ever done with my clothes on my entire life. Yes, and I did ask about Nick's sex life, that's true. Anyway, but I swear to God, I will play this one song if my fingers bleed all over the place. I'm going to do it because they hurt like hell.
That's for less than 3 minutes.
Yes,
at the end of less than 3 minutes.
Say I'm no good. Others say I'm no good. But I'm just a natural born traveling man doing what I
much as I can for a wedding song and a good guitar. The only thing that I understand, but boy, the only thing that I understand. Now that I'm a grown man, I travel here and there. I've learned that a bottle of brandy and a song are the only ones who ever care. Oh yeah, the only ones who ever care. And so my ex-wives. And I don't give a damn about a greenback dollar. Spend it fast as I can for a wedding song and a good guitar. The only thing that I understand. The only thing that I understand, oh, the only thing that I understand, oh yeah, the only thing that I understand.
One, two, one, yeah, big one, two, yeah.
And I don't give a damn about a greenback, a dollar. Spend it fast as I can for a wedding song and a good guitar. The only thing that I understand, oh yeah, the only thing that I understand.
Doggy Pano, the only thing that I understand.
By the way, you guys are a wonderful audience and make these guys feel really good and nuts too. You applaud you at the party last night.
Concert album, there was a record that was about to be put out, and the FBI put a quash on it. There were some questionable lyrics involved. It was called the Kingston Trio Frat Party. And this is one of the songs off of that.
Yeah.
Biff on stage, and we said, he can't be over 14 years old. Tell him what to do, Biff.
Well, I'm a professor of neurology at LSU Medical Center.
Can you believe it?
Do a little brain research.
See if you think I see
anything.
That's right.
Doing transplants. I just wanted to take an opportunity to thank the people that organized this. And get an opportunity also to say that, you know, kind of the older you get, the more I kind of realize that there are a lot of talented, bright people, but there aren't very many that spend time with the regular guys.
And we appreciate you doing that.
These guys are really great. I really love getting a chance to be here.
Done?
Okay,
you kick it off?
You got it.
All the good times are past and gone. Little darling, don't you weep no more. for his own true love, just like I search for mine. All the good times are past and gone. All the good times are over. All the good times are past and gone. Little darling, don't you weep no more. Come back, my own true love. Stay a while with me. If ever I had a friend in this world,
because you mentioned your daughter saying what you did. I moved to Oregon after I left the trio the first time, and my son Josh was about 8 years old, and we just were living way out in the country, and he was riding in the back of my pickup truck with some friends one day, and I overheard him somehow they asked him, "What does your dad do?" And he said, "He's a has-been."
Swear to God. True story.
Harold also is the one who wrote all the part of the books in the Guard Years and the Stewart Years. He wrote all of them.
Right.
He's our journalist.
He's our journalist on record.
And proud to be so. Thank you.
All right. Everybody sing this again.
Thank you.
Sharp. We'll see you in New York.
C Sharp.
St. Regis.
St. Regis.
St. Regis. I had them backwards. And they were tuning up. Bud had his guitar up here. He was tuning, and Travis was tuning, and Bud looked over and said, "Don't do that."
I believe you.
These little four-string guitars come pre-tuned from the factory.
I guess everybody's obliged to make a speech, and
no, they're not.
Just don't, right?
No, you don't.
I do, and I don't. There's one thing I've got to say. There was a little, I understand, snappy remark in a local paper about aging baby boomers that come out and do this sort of thing. And I've got to tell you, I've admired these guys like everybody else for more years than I care to tell. And aging is a far better alternative than anything else that I can think of.
Absolutely.
And having the opportunity to stand here with these guys, and I don't know that anybody's mentioned it tonight, but money from this camp goes to the Buffy Fund. John's wife, who is just the loveliest creature on this planet. And so to be privileged to stand here with these guys for this cause, I can't think of a better thing to do for an aging baby boomer.
Amen.
And I've got one other thing. I have a challenge for you folks here. And I hope this will make me play better, but I'm guessing it's probably not. But since that wonderful artwork goes to benefit Buffy, I want to open the bidding at $1,000. And so I challenge somebody here to do better than that.
All right.
Get Bob Shane on the phone.
Go down to that city, I say, for there's trouble.
all I had to hear them people say. If you don't look around, you won't see me going. See me going that way. If you don't look around, you have no way of knowing. I don't think you'll even know what I say.
Authenticated, I'd be glad to do that myself. I'll say, no, I didn't sign that, but I will now. But if you go on eBay and look under Kingston Trio Rare, that thing would go for a lot more than that. You could make money doing that. And, you know, whatever. It goes above some fun, too. Isn't that fascinating? I know all about you.
Thank you, Nick. Our next question comes from a woman in Tempe who asks, what about Amazon? Paul Jenkins, did we do Paul?
Yeah, Paul!
We all do drinks.
We all do Paul Lamb.
Out of
brother?
George!
Brother George!
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 Here comes George. You were last time.
But George was in the already called pile.
No, he wasn't.
You said to call someone else. You want to save George to last.
It's a rule.
It's a rule.
I was there last year. I was last.
That's tradition.
It's tradition. Now it's in my contract. I don't have any speeches to make.
Good. No, it's so sweet of all, you know. But it seems so strange, really, because we're just really never took ourselves very seriously, you know.
And, why would you?
No, but it's wonderful, it seems.
Don't get too close to the fans, they'll turn on you.
Earlier I asked John if I could do a particular song. And we have a list we're supposed to be working from. And,
That's cool.
He said, yeah, I could do it, but I'd have to do it solo, so.
What are you doing?
Oh boy.
Miss.
Yeah. We're getting on to the next part of the show.
What's that?
Camper of the year.
What?
Camper of the year.
Camper of the year. Come on,
like a.
You have to go to score. Camper of the year.
I had masking tape on my boot.
And that ain't all. The crops are all in and the pictures sound like
show that he has no qualities whatsoever. It's really the Mimo Camper of the Year. Mimo received Camper of the Year last year. Even though Mimo is my nephew, no one said there was a
no nepotism involved.
None. Campers loved Mimo. Mimo was about that tall. And Sam took her out of pity, and he sings like this. Richard Burns, he sings up like this. Fantastic. So, after much deliberation, meditation, channeling, I was channeling Tammy Faye just this afternoon. But I'd never get the makeup off. But I got it. The Camper of the Year is Dr. Vinyl.
Weather, I don't have any idea, but God knows I respect you.
Okay, picture with Camper of the Year.
Camper of the Year.
The what?
Prize.
Oh, prize, media. Oh, yeah. Actually, this should be a vinyl record, you understand, but that's okay. And I think I got them all, but that's
not a digital fan.
No.
Digital mind.
What the hell did I do to deserve this?
That's it. Nothing.
That's all right.
Nothing.
I would like to thank them both and all of you. Thank you very much for coming.